Tom went, and lots of people come up to me, autographs and all that, and then no one bothered Tom. 2 weeks later, we went to the India match, and by that time, Tom had his hair dyed.
Yes, yeah,
and blonde, and Tom becomes like a beacon in the crowd.
It is a beacon.
It does stand out. Tom, it is. Honestly,
there is no one out there who has this haircut. I regret to inform. I wish there'd be a mass of people so I could blend in slightly.
It's you and Billy Idol. You want to stand next to him.
That is it.
Thomas, age 7, wants to know if it's hard for you two to pretend not to be friends on film. I guess we kind of touched on that. But
hello, Thomas.
Is he age 7?
Thomas, age 7. I won't lie, actually. When we have close scenes together, I don't like to look into Daniel's eye directly.
You must make sure they laugh.
Because, yeah, this is the fear. Yeah. He's going to crack me up with a little look or something. So I usually stare at his eye.
I do it on purpose.
as a little tip there.
Yeah. I was once doing a scene with somebody who was doubling somebody else, and they decided that somebody was doing the lines off camera, and then this person was saying that they would mouth the lines for me, and it was a nightmare because he just looked like a badly dubbed Japanese film. And so it became very ridiculous. What I would do is look into a very, very bright light before the take, and then I'd do the scene. I wouldn't even be able to see his face because the retina burned.
That's the key.
Lots of people saying to me, I know you don't like your hair very much, but apparently you look very much like Stuart. I think it's not a good place to be.
That's what your girlfriend calls you.
I know.
Really?
The weird thing about this is that I went to a party, I don't know where it was, but it was a few months ago, in which I met Stuart Broad.
Really?
Yeah, and all their team came up to me and said, please take a photo with Stuart, if we take the mickey out of it and call him Malfoy. So it's not just on my half.
Is that his nickname, really?
Apparently he's been
even if it's not, I think we should start it.
So do I.
Let's start it.
Yeah. And Malfoy coming in for bowl.
I'd be honest.
Forgive me. He's the boy now, isn't he?
Isn't he just? I'm so glad that he's had his time. I'm so glad that he didn't. He was just talking that he didn't go to India for the for the summer, and he's here now, dedicated, and he's being rewarded.
That's actually a very good point, and I think a lot of us have perhaps overlooked.
That's what we think, is that even if he doesn't, even if it didn't do any, he proved his commitment to the side by not going, and I think think it's really, really admirable in somebody as young as he is. I think for whom money is obviously going to be an issue, and there's a huge amount of financial draw to go to that series. I think it was really, really admirable that he stayed behind.
Fantastic commitment, dedication.
But we've had today. Sorry,
was
your arm?
No, the arm rest.
Last 2 days we've had you two and Lily Allen here. Three.
Yeah, it's all a bit starring.
High-profile people who love cricket, and she was very adamant about liking Test cricket and the image of that.
Oh yeah.
Now, are you two the same?
Oh yeah, absolutely. I mean, I read something Sachin Tendulkar had said recently, which was that 2020 is a, I think he said it's a dessert, and you can't eat dessert all the time, and it's absolutely right. You know, it's great fun. It was interesting this year because the 2020, the domestic competition in England seemed to suffer from the fact that the world competition had been here because sort of everyone was distracted by it.
Yeah.
But I do think, it's a great sport, and it's what's wonderful is that it gives young cricketers a real chance to shine against the best bowlers. But it's not all that you can, it hasn't, particularly for us as actors, it's, Test cricket is a play set in 5 acts.
Yeah,
that's what it is. And it is drama, and it is exciting. And when you see, the particular innings I remember is Andrew Strauss coming out to bat. I can't remember where it was, but I mean, it was in New Zealand. I can't remember which ground. But for that last innings, where it's good, I think 166, was it? 177.
Yeah, yeah.
And you knew he was coming out, and if he didn't do well, that could have potentially been his career.
Correct. It was in Napier, yes.
Napier,
it was the most prettiest thing in the world, but it was an important
one. Not the prettiest, but I don't like pretty. I don't
really?
Mind that. I like gritty as opposed to pretty.
Yeah,
it was wonderful. And the fact that he's now England captain, you feel you have watched a journey and evolution, and it's wonderful. And that's what I particularly love about sport is the romance about it, and the history. It's
most
nothing can surpass it. Yeah. Oh, well, thank you.
Beautiful.
But in 3 years, when we last chatted, you really have grown to cricket, haven't you? It's very evident.
Yeah, I mean, I am Mr. Thorough. For a while, I was quite worried because I was in, every time I went to a match, I was in all the papers as, Daniel Radcliffe, Harry Potter, comes to every cricket match that he's ever played and just wants to hang out with the players, which I do. I've met some of the
who
players.
Who have you met now?
Who have I met now?
3 years ago, wasn't it great, where you asked Andrew Strauss?
I'm an autograph, and he wasn't even aware of it.
He doesn't polished one off, and then I had to bring an autograph book for him to get you to sign to take out his children.
It was a wonderful moment. You know, I've met, I sort of occasionally, I'm in contact with Sean Udall and Ryan Sidebottom, and me and Sean Udall have a couple of lovely chats occasionally about cricket. We get on the phone and complain to each other. But he's
you're a Middlesex fan, are you?
It's tough because I'm sort of. I sort of got adopted by the Middlesex team because basically when I went to the 2020 finals last year, I was a Durham fan and I was going there for Durham and I still support Durham and I love watching them and because of Colley, because of Harmison and because of a couple of, you know, I love Phil Mustard. I love watching him play.
I
love Graham Onions Man, not in the same way possibly that Lily Allen likes Graham Onions, but I still very much enjoy watching him bowl. But I went there and I sort of, in the normal way that I do, which is pretty much how I got into this commentary box today, sort of blagged my way back into a place where I could talk to loads of people I admire. And I ended up meeting loads of people last year, including the Middlesex team, and they sort of half adopted me. I actually got a text from one of the team not that long ago. And it's kind of lovely. I feel like a bit of a chancer having been texted by so many people that I admire. I don't feel I sort of belong here. Literally, me and Tom and Jade walked out onto this the balcony that you guys have got. I just went, oh my god, we will never be able to watch cricket again. We are watching it from the greatest standpoint that you can possibly imagine.
That's great though, isn't it? Tom, you get the chance to see this live.
Yes, I very luckily Dan managed to angle me a ticket.
It's Shilpa, you see.
It is a big shout out to Shilpa. We are very much indebted to her.
It's no joke that this
she's like a broody hen clucking around you.
She's amazing. She does great work. No, there's no joke that Dan works very hard, and obviously we get a lot of time on set, so it's great to be able to spend a day down here and really thoroughly enjoy cricket at its best, really.
Questions about comparing cricket with Quidditch.
Make this analogy. I want to hear this.
Cricket's real and Quidditch is a fictional sport played by me on a blue screen.
You're going to shatter lots of illusions.
I know. It's yeah.
There are some similarities. Come on. There's a ball.
There's a ball. You know what I like? The thing I like about Quidditch, which is probably similar to cricket, is the fact that it's needlessly complex. It's fantastically complicated. And that, I suppose, is a similarity with cricket. I like the fact that the rules in cricket are so kind of mad.
Impossible.
And it's impossible. I like the fact that it's a sport that it's impossible to explain to somebody.
Oh, good lord. Yes. You'll be there for days.
Yes, you can. Are you up on the laws and things?
Oh, very Tom, much Tom's so. A big
but we've,
fan.
We've dragged my girlfriend here for about, this is like the sixth time I've dragged her now, and she's well and truly, you know, she understands the...
You're getting into it, aren't you, James?
Yeah. She loves it. She knows the players, she knows Broad very well, and she knows everyone else, so it's great. Yeah, it's nice to bring someone.
Those people work very well just because you look like
it. Yes, thank you, Dan. You know, he's cut his
long
hair.
Who thinks you are him, actually? That's the danger.
Only he's like 3 foot taller. When we had a photo together, I physically looked abnormal next to him.
Yeah.
He is huge.
Yeah, well, Tom, you've got a good 3 inches on me, Tom.
Well, let's not go in there.